I will put it, and I will guarantee you've got to talk to people. We've gotten to a point, I'm going to get on a soapbox. It'll be real short, I promise. I think we've gotten so automated, we forgot the human aspect, the human mathematical formulation of getting another person to say, hey, let's do this deal, okay? And maybe we lost that. Good morning, Christina.
Hello.
Are you one of Justin's posse?
Yes, I'm actually with Wick.
With
Victor? She's my partner. She's my partner. Yeah.
Oh, you guys can't share the same stream? Is this a marital difficulty or what?
We're in the same room, but
you're in the same room on separate screens. I love it. Yeah. It's a great country or what? Really. We think we can text, we can email, we can delegate to people who don't have our skill sets or our motivation. We think we can delegate our business. I don't like to use bad language, but there's such BS about succeeding in business that you can automate everything. You can put it in your click funnel and everything. And that's wonderful if you're Elon Musk and you're building, you want to build 100,000 electric cars a year. But most people, I think, are what we want to be kitchen table millionaires. Does anyone know what I mean by that? What does that mean?
Relationships.
What's a kitchen table? Just think of yourself in the kitchen on a nice wooden table. We have a beautiful, I'm in San Diego, but in Colorado, we have this beautiful handmade wooden table. It's just a simple round table. I love taking my computer upstairs and working from it and drinking my wife's very good French roast coffee, and from that one table with no employees, and good Wi-Fi and good computer equipment, I can run a whole business. Mm. I can put mac and cheese on the table. Christina, you were going to share.
I was thinking that something along more of the lines of conversational, how is your day type of.
Yeah. What happens when we talk to somebody and they have a problem? Here's the big thing. This market is changing right now. We're getting into a low supply, high demand. We're coming out of that since 2009. We've had a great free ride, okay? But are things changing right now? We talked a great deal about this on my Monday group training. Things are changing right now. Is anybody looking at the prices in the supermarket? Forget about the gas pump. Have you seen what's going on out there? Right? What's going on, Vic?
Water used to be, you can get those jugs. You can get them for like a dollar. You used to. Now they're like 130 something, 140.
Yeah.
I love this overpriced French fuzzy water. Okay. I think it was a case was like $6.99. I think it's like $12, $13 now. When did this double?
Wow.
It's water from France. Who knows what's in it, you know?
Yeah.
Albert, what do you think? Albert, with the universe behind you there.
Hey, Claude, can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, sir. What do you think about all this drivel I'm spouting out today?
It's great stuff. Stuff I'd hear on YouTube videos whenever I'm on your channel.
Why is my vision purpose so contrary? I'm not a contrarian. I'm really not. I'm a glasses half full. I'm an optimist. But why is my viewpoint so different from my 99% competition in so many aspects? Why am I such a damn oddball?
You're a funny oddball.
I like to laugh a lot. I think life is short. You should enjoy it. I think the person who said money isn't everything was psychotic or something. Money's so important. Okay. You want to live like a good human being. You want to be philanthropic. You want to help your causes and make sure your kids go to good dental colleges or whatever. You got to have some butt. Life is easier. You can make good decisions when money is not a factor in that decision-making process. True or false?
True.
Ooh, it's kind of
true.
Ooh, opinionated. Totally true. Oh my God, he's got opinions. This is crazy. Don't do it, Claude. I think and the thing about this wonderful business we call real estate, it's changing now. The one change that we're seeing that we haven't seen for years, who knows what it is? What's the big change now?
It's a buyer's market.
It's a buyer's market. What does that mean, Steve? Good answer.
Interest rates going up.
That means that a lot of buyers have a little bit more control than sellers were. They can basically kind of like set the tone, set their environment, set what they want for it. So it's a little bit going to be tougher negotiating. Buyers say, hey, this is what I want. If you want it, great. If you don't, go someplace else.
Are we seeing, what's the, every guru at every seminar in the 80s and 90s, they always said, find the, it's their mantra. Somebody must have a tattoo on it by now. Find the motivated seller, right? Okay. Yeah. They've got it on one arm and SpongeBob on the other. Okay. Find the motivated seller. What is a motivated seller? Let's define that before we get into some role plays here. What is a motivated seller? Someone unmute and jump in. What is that?
Someone who probably has like a life transition. Something has to happen. They have to get rid of, they have a problem with their property.
A problem with their, oh, I like
the money.
He said one word. I love, what was that one word he said, Albert? That one word in that answer from Michael.
There's a problem.
Who said problem? Everybody, problem. Do people have problems now? The owners of properties, the investors, are they starting? What did we hear? How many of you read these articles? There was a great article from Ani and Chantel on the Skype group yesterday. What do we start? And then I posted one from Bruce Norris, who's a great statistician in California. Bruce has called at least three of the recessions, depressions, and things that we've had here on the left coast, okay? Basically, we're seeing foreclosures and evictions. Where are they going?
Up.
All of a sudden, we're seeing that. Did anyone have time? If somebody 4 years ago, and they were, had a four, and they couldn't make their payments, how fast could they sell their home?
In a minute.
Yeah. And then we had the pandemic and government interference, both state and federal interfered with a moratorium on evictions and on foreclosures. So now we're in a new place. This is the thing, change is constant, isn't it?
Yes.
Now we're in a place where people are starting to have problems, as Michael said. Well, what kind of problems do you think people are having now in these? The young couple, they bought their first home for $750,000 in East Bumble, California, in the desert somewhere. Steve Zobro probably sold them the land.
No, it was West Bumble.
And they're both husband and wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, they're working. Yeah. They both make $60,000 to $100,000 a year. Young couple, they have three chihuahuas. And 65-70% of their income is going to this their first home, which is a big change for millennials and Gen Xers. They're paying a much greater portion of their total income than we ever paid in my generation. Okay, we paid about 35% of our total income was for our house, you know, and then it went up to 50. Now I'm reading 67%. Of younger people, of their income. That doesn't leave much after taxes and a couple a couple trips to Grubhub and stuff, a couple deliveries to Grubhub, right?
Right.
It doesn't leave much.
Plus, when the couple is maybe, the husband has maybe 150 mile an hour drive to work, you got gas and all that stuff. It's like, we don't have the money, man. How are we going to do this?